Jan Böning is going home. The 33-year-old politician often has to cover the entire city in a day. And to do so, he often travels by car. Not his own, though. He shares it with 40 others.
I've never had my own car, but there are moments when it's practical. Sometimes you want to transport things, which is difficult with just a bike and backpack. That's when I get a car. I'm a regular now. I use it for things I would never have before.
You used to have to return the car to the pickup point, but now you can drop it off anywhere. An app shows where the nearest available car is. You do a quick inspection, and if you're satisfied with how the previous customer left it, you jump in and drive away. It costs Böning about 30 cents per minute to use the car. He doesn't have to worry about filling it up, cleaning it, repairs, or even parking fees. The company takes care of that. Once Böning drops it off, it's out of his hands.
If I want to go out at night for a beer, I can drive there and go home on the train. And I don't have to go back the next morning to pick up my car. I just leave my house, look up the nearest car on my phone, drive it, and then just leave it.
Böning can choose the car that suits him best, whatever the situation. Sunshine, rain, parking in small spaces, or big shopping trips. Car sharing is catching on. In Germany, the number of users has doubled in the past 3 years to more than 500,000. The status of car ownership has also changed, says mobility expert Frank Wolter.
Owning your own car has lost its significance for the current generation. It's more about being able to use one. In cities, there's nothing special anymore about driving a certain brand of car.
The younger generation would rather spend their money on travel or on a new smartphone. If they do buy a car, it's usually much later in life. So the car industry is now selling mobility instead of just a physical product. Companies want to bring car sharers to their brand. The traditional days of car ownership are indeed changing.
Things will get easier. We're not going to go crazy dealing with 5 different price ranges from 8 manufacturers. There'll be one system for the city. That means that mobility will be better and that owning your own car will become rarer in urban areas.
It seems to be a win-win situation, but car sharing still only makes sense for people who live in big cities. And for those who have to drive every day or drive long distances, it can get expensive quickly. But for Böning, it's the perfect solution. Simple, flexible, and economical.
It's stressful having your own car. Repairs, parking, gas. With car sharing, I don't have those problems. I get my car whenever I need it. It's usually someplace close and ready to go.
And that's how Jan Böning will continue to travel, driving cars that don't belong to him, just so long as there's one available.